If you're not using expressions, then what the fuck? I mean, no worries. I got you. I know that they can be intimidating. I mean, I didn't get into this career thinking that I was going to learn how to do JavaScript coding, you know? Because that's what they are, little lines of code to basically get your graphics to do what you want without you having to keyframe every little thing and have a million different layers that you're going to have to manually change. So it's really great for speeding up your workflow, decluttering your comps because you can use less keyframes and layers, and it makes it really easy to adjust the animation by just changing a few little values. So it's kind of like a script, but where a script tells the app to do something and expression tells the property to do something. And if I, the person who used to pretend to have a stomach ache and hid in the bathroom crying whenever she had a math or computer lesson, can learn how to use expressions, then so can you. And you know, if you really want to be a professional motion designer or motion graphics artist, you need to learn when the best times are to use expressions. Like, for example, if you've got an action that needs to cycle through the same few keyframes, or something that needs to happen continuously or repetitively, or something that needs to happen over time, it makes sense to use an expression and not go and keyframe every single little part of that. Or, you know, if you have a lot of layers that all need to do something and you need to be able to easily control them and adjust them, like for instance, the color property or something like that, rather than going and adjusting that on each and every individual layer, you can link that property to a main controller with an expression and just adjust all of them there in one place. There are obviously a ton of other examples and uses for expressions, and they run the whole gamut of the super simple, easy ones where you really actually don't need to have much coding experience at all because After Effects basically does it for you, to the ones that are really, really complicated but give you so much more control and adaptability over what you're doing. Because this is for beginners, I'm obviously going to look at the simpler ones for this video. But in a nutshell, if you are a motion designer or a motion graphics artist and you want to be really good at what you do, you need to learn how to use expressions. Any property that you can keyframe, you can add an expression to, like position, rotation, opacity, scale, keyframeable properties on effects you've applied, anything you can keyframe. All you have to do is in the timeline, reveal the property that you want to add the expression to and alt click, or option click if you're on a Mac, on the keyframe icon. That's that little stopwatch looking dude. And you'll see the expression field open up. That's where you'll put your expression and the properties turn red. You can enable or disable the expression by toggling this equals button over here. For some expressions, you can literally just use the pick whip to link properties, which will automatically generate the syntax for you, so you don't even have to do anything. After Effects generates that code for you. So for instance here, I want this donut to scale up and down and to keep doing this forever. What I first need to do is show it what I want it to do, which is start at 100% scale, then scale down to 50%, then scale back up to 100%. So now I've laid the groundwork to add an expression to tell it to keep doing this. I alt-click on the stopwatch in the scale property, then in the expression field, I just start typing in loop here, and I get a bunch of options for looping my keyframes. I'm gonna go with just this loop out expression, which means that it'll keep looping after the last keyframe, while loop in means it will loop before the first keyframe. And that's literally it. I can add values in those brackets there or just leave it. Check it out. It'll just keep looping like that forever. If I use this arrow guy over here to give me a bit more guidance, maybe I do want to use certain values or don't want it to just cycle like this. Maybe I want it first to do something, then loop only the last few keyframes, for instance. I can go to properties, loop out, and then it comes now with these hints on what I can use there. I'm going to keep it at cycle, but I want it to first animate all whack like this. And then loop just these last few keyframes. So because loop out is based on the last keyframe, it loops from the last keyframe like I said before. We need to count backwards from the last keyframe for what we want to loop. So if I wanted to just scale up and down between these last two keyframes, I'm going to put in 2. And now we'll first play out the original keyframes and then continue looping between those last two for the rest of the comp. Isn't that exhilarating? No? Okay, well, maybe I just need to get out more. So let's look at another one that's super simple and pretty useful. Okay, so let's say we have these shapes, right? And we want them all to rotate at the same pace, but it's a super drag to have to go and keyframe each one rotating. All you need to do is alt-click on the rotation property of each one so that this expression gets made. Then use the pick whip and pick whip it to the rotation property of a master layer, which can be any one of those shapes. So this will drive the others, and you only need to keyframe this one. So easy, so convenient. Now, let's say we also want to be able to control the color of all of these so that, say the client decides they hate the color pink and now they want them to be blue. Rather than having to go through every single one and change the color to blue, only for the client to say tomorrow that they rather want green, you can use an expression and again a master control layer. So we can make an adjustment layer, let's call it master color, and add an effect to it called an expression control, which is up here in effects, and then, would you believe it, expression controls. Then we select the one called color control. Then just toggle down there so that the color property is visible, and then in the other layers, toggle them down too, so we can see the full color property. Then alt-click the stopwatch to add the expression. Then we use the pick whip to go back up here to the master control layers color property, and do that for all the layers. You can also, as a little bit of a shortcut, because it does get a little bit tedious going through every single layer and pick whipping each one to the property, you can go to one where you've already got the right expression on. You select the property that has the expression, you go to edit, and then copy expression only. Then you go to the next one that doesn't have the expression on it yet, you click on the property, and you literally just paste it there, Control V if you're on Windows. So you can do this on every layer instead of pick whipping and dragging it up to the master layer every time. And then you see here, when you adjust this one, all the others change with the two. And you can keyframe this, so it can even change over time. Just some tips when working with expressions. Sometimes you'll get an error, and it could be a really easy fix, so don't panic if you don't understand, you know, the scripting language. If you click on the error icon, it'll tell you what line and kind of what the error is. They are case sensitive, so if I do this and change this to lowercase, I'll get an error telling me where it went wrong. So that's useful for troubleshooting if you're typing in a word for an expression or if you're typing in your own expression. Just be mindful of the fact that it is case sensitive. Make sure you're using the right upper and lowercase letters, and make sure you use a semicolon at the end of a statement so that After Effects knows that that's the end of the statement. In some situations, you might want to convert an expression to keyframes. You can do that by going to the timeline panel and go to Animation, Keyframe Assistant, Convert Expression to Keyframes. The expression is still there, it's just disabled. Now, obviously, the expressions that I showed you now were super simple, super basic, and obviously, they're much more versatile than that. You can do a lot more with expressions and they can get very, very complicated, like I said before. But for the purposes of this video, since it's just a jump off for beginners, hopefully I just managed to convince you that firstly, expressions are very necessary if you want to be a motion designer. Obviously, if you're a hobbyist and you don't want to get into them, it's all good, you do you. But if you want to be a professional, they are actually quite crucial. So hopefully you don't find them so daunting anymore if you did before or if you just didn't understand them. Hopefully I've helped you understand them a little bit better. And you can see now the true advantages of it and how much it can really speed up your workflow and cut out a lot of the headaches that you have to battle with when you're keyframing something manually and you really don't need to. If you haven't subscribed yet, well, that door's always open, so don't be a stranger. Hit the like button if you did like the video and to help out with the algorithm, and also just so that I can know what sort of videos people like so I can make more of them. Thank you so much as always to my wonderful patrons. Thank you to my wonderful patrons. The support is so gratifying and I really do appreciate it. Thanks for watching, guys. Love ya. Bye.